Parterre Box, the queer opera scene, presents Unnatural Acts of Opera, the only podcast where opera is king and you, the listeners, are queens. And now, here's your hostess, La Cheka.
Hello again, cher public, and La Cheka does hope that you approve of our new once-weekly podcast schedule. It takes a bit of the pressure off your old friend La Cheka, and so we've been told, the regular part of the schedule makes it easier to keep up with the latest shows. So do keep in mind, from here on out, that you can expect a new Unnatural Acts of Opera each Thursday night, and for extra fun, you can start an over-under on how long it will be before La Cheka screws up and gets off the schedule.
I'd like a piece of that, La Cheka.
You'll get a piece of my mind if you don't behave, Milton.
Now, be fair, La Cheka. Remember that I'm co-producer on this show, and so it's at least partially my responsibility to meet deadlines and to deliver the deliverables.
Indeed, I had forgotten that, Milton. And so it follows that, as co-producer of this show, you're also responsible for keeping it on schedule.
I am. Oh, yes, I am. Moving
just
right along.
Just testing you, Milton. Well done.
Thank you, La Cheka, but actually, we should be moving along.
Oh, must we, Milton? Can't it wait until tomorrow?
Now, La Cheka, are you going to disappoint your cher public again?
Again? Well played, Milton. You really do keep me on my toes.
And so, perhaps you could tell us a little about tonight's opera.
But of course, Milton. Tonight's opera is concerned with what die-hard opera queens call the sacro fuoco. Though they don't always sound like Stefan Zucker when they do it. In fact, the sacro fuoco in tonight's opera is not a metaphor for artistic dedication, but a real fire, that is, the ritual flame that must be kept burning unceasingly in the temple of Vesta.
It should be noted that the soprano who sings the leading role in this opera does possess the metaphorical version of the sacro fuoco, because our prima donna in this performance of Spontini's La Vestale is the magnificent Leila Genzer.
Yes, La Genzer is heard in this opera as Julia, a priestess in the cult of Vesta in ancient Rome, and the opera is named for her, La Vestale. Now notice that La Cheka says Vestale, not Vestale, because this work is done in Italian translation in a performance from the Teatro Massimo in Palermo in December of 1969.
The opera begins in Rome circa 269 BC. A young commander, Licinius, has returned to Rome in triumph. However, he is filled with dread.
Now, why would that be, Milton?
He tells his friend, Cinna, that his beloved Julia has joined the cult of Vesta, the goddess of the hearth, while he has been off campaigning in Gaul.
That doesn't seem so bad. Oh, well, go on.
Julia asks the head priestess that she be excused from the festivities honoring the commander, but her request is denied. As Julia presents Licinius with the golden wreath, he whispers to her that he plans to abduct her that very evening.
Obviously, he's brought some of that gall back with him to Rome.
Now, La Cheka, isn't that an exciting premise for a first act?
Well, we'll find out, Milton. Here we are with the first act of La Vestale.
Thank you. Ti posso, Giulia. mia, sì, questo oggetto di terrore l'affetto fu dalla madre un tempo promessa alla mia fe, ma il cavaltero d'un illustre famiglia a donarmi la figlia allor che gloria la mia stirpe ignorava il nome mio. Poteva indorsi mai al canto il fincolai nobile ambizione col mezzo dei felici miei sudori segnalò la mia vita dopo il lustro vincitore alla patria. Io por ritorno per la speranza di quel ben che attendo il cor mi neria ai barbara sciagura perdimi il fato Giulia agli alcani obbligata oimè al moribondo genitore tradito i giuramenti a dell'amore. Io ti compiango e poco il compiangermi esperi ulma, ma stanco di averso io ad un fatal trasporto non porti in preda. Pensa leggi ai dei che offende l'amor tuo, credente in loro son l'ira e la vendetta. Avrò subir la sorte che m'aspetta. Dal mio ardimento i guai perigli io proverò l'orrore, i guai perigli io proverò l'orrore.
Oh, Oh!
giorno è il frutto del valor. Qual domino di lor e siedi a pieno.
And so we leave our Vestal Virgin teetering on the brink of disqualification for her office, but we'll find out more about that in the second act of Spontini's opera La Vestale.
Yes, Milton. Once again on Unnatural Acts of Opera, La Cieca has the sad duty of announcing the passing of another celebrated singer. This time it's Rose Bampton, the American dramatic soprano who died yesterday at the age of 99. We have a recording of Miss Bampton performing the great aria from Alceste.
Thank you.
And so I believe you and I are about done here for another week, Lachega.
Optimistically, yes, for exactly a week. Until the next time, our cher public joins us right here on Unnatural Acts of Opera.
Parterre Box, the queer opera scene, presents Unnatural Acts of Opera, the only podcast where opera is king and you, the listeners, are queens. And now, here's your hostess, La Chega.
So yet another Thursday has crept up on us, dear Milton, and you know what that means.
Reruns of The Office? Oh, I just love that show. You know, it's funny because it's so true. You know, that one time, you know, there was this one
course,
time...
Of course, yes, the Office, that would be my first answer too, Milton. The Office, given that the two of us produce The Office each week and all...
What are you talking about, Lachega? We don't produce The Office. We produce Unnatural Acts of Opera.
Exactly, Milton.
Oh, I get it. Thursday is all about the Unnatural Acts.
Yes.
And The Office.
That too, but first, the opera. We are continuing this week with Spontini's opera La Vestale in a performance in Italian translation from the Teatro Massimo in Palermo in December of 1969.
And starring Leila Genser as Julia, of course.
Of course. Tonight we hear the second act of La Vestale, which reminds La Cieca of something she heard. One might say that, taken as a whole, the second act of La Vestale is but one gigantic crescendo. Hey, what's that from? One gigantic crescendo.
How would I know?
Oh, come on, what's it from? You know.
Lachega.
What's it from, for Christ's sake?
What's that from?
I just told you, I just did it. One might say that, taken as a whole, the second act of La Vestale is but one gigantic crescendo. Huh, what's that from?
I haven't the faintest idea.
Dumbbell, it's from some goddamn Hector Berlioz essay, some goddamn chapter of Soiree de l'Orchestre.
I can't remember all the
essays. Nobody's asking you to remember every single goddamn Soiree de l'Orchestre, just one single little soiree.
The 13th. It was the 13th chapter of the Soiree de l'Orchestre by Hector Berlioz.
Was it?
Yes, the 13th.
Well, anyway, Hector comes in and he looks around and he puts his groceries down and he says, one might say that, taken as a whole, the second act of La Vestale is but one gigantic crescendo.
I would agree with
you. Oh, well, so would I. Anyway, perhaps you could fill us in, cluck, on what happens in the second act of La Vestale.
Julia, who is a Vestal virgin, as you remember, is on duty standing watch before the sacred flame which must never go out. She prays to Vesta for deliverance from her sinful love. And yet, she races to open the temple doors to allow Licinio entry.
To the temple, you mean?
When Licinio arrives, he swears to free her from her obligations. As they declare their love, the sacred flame suddenly goes out.
Well, that's the main obligation right there. You know, she's just not cut out for this virgin stuff.
Cinna warns Licinio to escape at once. The Pontifex Maximus, or High Priest, arrives and accuses Julia of perfidy. He demands to know the name of the intruder, but Julia refuses to give the name. She is then cursed, stripped of her vestal garments, and sentenced to death.
My, that does sound like a gigantic crescendo, and we haven't even heard the music yet. So by all means, let's now hear the second act of Spontini's La Vestale.
Thank you. Conosci il mio coraggio, or Oh,
primo recinto strepito sode, andiamo in volare ci possiamo, tra l'ombre e la notte, nei momenti che il destin ci concede, or profittiamo. Vedi quell'ara, estinto il divin fuoco, e poi ch'io l'abbandoni.
Qui la presenza tua un giorno può mia sorte, anzi l'orror di morte si t'aspeme m'ingombra.
Seguimi, andia, verrà al suo fato, così spio della via. La disperatia sarà un giuria, oh, follia.
Io la voglio, e qui
Supremo,
As Milton and I discussed earlier, Hector Berlioz wrote quite a bit about La Vestale.
Yes, in the Soirée de l'Orchestre and elsewhere.
Yes, but we're not going to quote dear Hector anymore. His critical writings are available on the web and certainly worth picking up again, as dear Roz Russell would say.
But La Ceca and I did think it would be interesting to hear at least a fragment of La Vestale in its original language, and so here is a chunk of the second act as performed en français. This is a 1964 radio concert of La Vestale featuring René Mazella and Jean Moulin with Jean-Paul Crédier conducting.
Thank you.
Yeah.
j'aimerais te voir.
Oh, quel lieu!
Le Dieu qui nous rassemble veille autour de ses murs et prend soin de tes jours.
Je ne crains que pour toi.
Des dangers que tu cours, j'ai repoussé l'image. Par ce terrible effort, juge de mon courage. N'est-il donc point d'asile au milieu des forêts, sous un ciel étranger, dans quelque antre sauvage? Dis un mot, un seul mot, d'un affreux esclavage, je puis encore t'affranchir.
Non, jamais.
Les dieux prendront pitié du sort qui nous accable. Ils ont jeté sur nous regard favorable. Fille du ciel, idole de mon cœur, sois à jamais l'arbitre de ma ville. Un seul de tes regards est pour moi le bonheur. Oh, cet Dieu, allons porter en vie. Va, cet Dieu, à nous porter en vie. Vénus doit à l'amour son appui protecteur. C'est elle que mon cœur atteste.
Éloigne-toi de cette hôtel funeste. Le feu pâlit.
Chaste divinité, dissipe un sinistre présage. Tout mon crime, Vesta, c'est d'aimer ton image. Et nos feux ont des tiens, toute la pureté.
Oh, bonheur, je viens de naître du passé. Je n'ai plus qu'un faible souvenir, un nuage à mes yeux s'étend sur l'avenir. Et l'instant où je suis réuni.
Quel transport! Je suis auprès de toi.
Quel transport!
De tes regards, mon cœur s'enivre.
À l'amour seul, mon cœur se livre.
De tes regards.
Son ivresse,
son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son ivresse, son
Winds up the musical portion of our program this evening.
Or, as we might call it, our soirée de l'orchestre.
We might call it that, Milton, but La Chica prefers not to argue.
In the interest of getting to the living room in time to see The Office, I will agree with you, La Chica.
Then we are both content until this time next week on Unnatural Acts of Opera.
First, let's go over some parameters. How many people can I fire?
None. You're picking a healthcare plan.
Okay, we'll table that for the time being.
Parterre Box, the queer opera scene, presents Unnatural Acts of Opera, the only podcast where opera is king and you, the listeners, are queens. And now, here's your hostess, La Chica.
Hello, everyone. La Chica here, as usual. But I'm afraid nothing else is as usual at all. First, of course, we've postponed the third act of La Vestale a couple of days, so we could do a podcast honoring the great Luciano Pavarotti, and you know, La Chica is a little ashamed to say that it's been a long time since she's listened to really prime Pavarotti, the real wealth of recorded material that's been showing up on television, radio, and the web in tribute to his life and career. As La Chica said, we do have a little tribute of our own up on the web, but we'll work on a more extensive series of podcasts in the next few weeks. In the meantime, we have La Vestale, and, well, you see, that brings us to our problem, which is that La Chica's dear sidekick Milton Host is not in the studio today, and so La Chica is rather nervous about going it alone again after such a long time. You see, cher public, dear Milton, like so many young artistic types here in New York, holds down a day job, which in his case is at a midtown law firm, and he was called in for an emergency shift yesterday. The problem is now he has no way to make it to our lovely Sunnyside studios, what with this taxi strike going on. Well, that about does it for what La Chica has to say. Milton, you know, was going to relate to you the story of the third act of La Vestale, and La Chica, frankly, can't find the script for that. So, well, I hardly know just what to do. I suppose we could ring dear Milton up at his office and have him tell the story over the telephone. Oh, of course. Why didn't I think of that earlier? Do bear with me for just a moment, cher public, while I phone Milton's law firm.
An apple, I've been black.
Yes, Milton Host, please.
Whitcomb got an apple, I've been black.
Hello, may I speak to...
Oh, yes, long distance. How are you?
Hello? Hello, it's Claude there.
Oh, but you see, I'm not Claude.
Hello, darling. Yes, this is Tallulah.
I'm afraid I'm not calling for Tallulah. I wanted to speak
to... Now, Claude, you needn't try to disguise your voice. I know it anyway.
I'm afraid I have the wrong number.
Oh, joke.
Mr. Whittaker, I have your San Francisco call for you. Yes, Mr. Vibman?
Yes, I'd like... Would you...
Hello?
Yes, I'd like... Hello? Would you...
Mais non, madame.
Oh, I...
Nous sommes plusieurs sur la ligne. Raccrochez. Vous êtes avec une abonnée.
Est-ce que je
vous... Mais madame, raccrochez-vous-même.
Oh!
Allô, mademoiselle?
Pardon, mais je ne parle pas.
Ce n'est pas le docteur Schmidt.
Please! You have reached Vibicombe, Gutterman, Applewhite, Vibberman, and Black. Your call is very important to us. No one is available at the moment to take your call, Please continue to hold. If you know your party's extension, you may dial it at any time. For accounts payable, please press 1. For bookkeeping, please press 2. For larger...
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Who is this, please?
This is La Cheka.
Yes, this is Blanche Hudson.
Oh, hello, Miss Hudson.
What seems to be the trouble?
I'm trying to reach Milton Host. He works there at Biddicombe, you know, and...
I'm afraid there's been some misunderstanding.
Milton Host.
I certainly didn't mean to suggest that you
should... Oh, should I try a different department?
Would you please?
Could you transfer me back to the switchboard, please?
I'll put her on.
Milton Host, please.
Hello, hello.
Milton Host, please.
You, I am so glad you called. I was just thinking of you. It's been a long time since you called me.
I just want to talk to Milton Host.
Oh, I cannot come tonight.
Excuse me, miss...
Oh, my dear, I'm not feeling very well.
He works there at this law firm, Biddicombe, and I'm... I want to...
Yep, I'm leaving in the morning.
No, actually,
what?
It's not.
Oh,
I
sure,
want
the
to...
party's going fine. I'm sorry you and Bess couldn't make
Bess?
It.
Bess? How do I... I don't know how...
Is Margaret with you?
No, actually, Margaret is talking to Eleanor right now on another line and...
Did anyone call?
Actually, I've been calling all over the company and...
I don't suppose...
Hello?
So.
Oh, heaven. I feel like I'm trapped in a lip-syncer show.
Hello.
Hello. May I speak
yes,
to...
Yes, this is Jane, baby.
Yes, hello, Jane, baby. I really want to speak to Milton Host, and I'm wondering
you
if I could...
You want what?
Yes, is that such a problem?
A girl like me?
What do you want from me?
What do I want?
La Cheka is terribly sorry, cher public. Let's see,
Hello, you've reached the voicemail for Milton Host. If you want to leave a message, please press 1. If you want to retrieve messages, please press 2. If you want to hear the synopsis of the third act of La Vestale, please press 3. If you want to leave another message, you... Julia is to be buried alive. Licinio and Cinna plead for mercy. The Pontifex Maximus is unyielding. Licinio confesses that he is to blame, but Julia claims that she does not know him. She is led before the altar and climbs down into the open grave. A storm envelops the temple. A lightning bolt ignites Julia's veil that had fallen near the altar, and the sacred flame is rekindled. Licinio and Cinna rescue Julia from the grave. The high priestess recognizes divine intervention, and all are forgiven. Julia is freed from her vows. Licinio takes Julia's hand and leads her to the altar, where they are married.
Well, La Cheka is glad someone found a happy ending. Here, then, is the third act of La Vestale.
Thank you.
correndo, disposto all'apparato, vittima d'altra legge, la beltade, la giovinezza, in preda dei carnefici, viva nella bomba, discenderà. Armare via, a te pur lascia i modi, la somma lor clemenza. Vengo per Giulia a chiederti assistenza.
E ardisci domandar, mentre lo Stato la salvezza di Roma, una vittima anduopo.
Oh, un merito. Oh, il bene degli stati non dipende.
Quei nottuosi tormenti assai mi dimostran che mai tali misfatti perdonona Dea.
Vado per Ivea, allor che nacque la fatal tua legge. Una vestale in seno Marte mi die la vita.
Giulia deve morir.
Non pia mai temo. Suo complice son io, o salvarla o morire, o lei desio.
Amorra. E insultar tu osi, debole scudo e il tuo valore stesso. Nata arpea rupe, e al campi d'aglia appresso.
O sai, dovrai tremare, o sai, dovrai agli stegni e tira il tuo crudere al mare, il tuo crudere al mare, al canto suotero, al canto suotero.
Ma voi core di un mare sopra di te.
Provar dovrai il mio segno, se Giulia te mi dà.
Vieni, può tuo di degno, il ciel componderà.
Oh, i miei,
tremo,
tremo,
compagni, tu
non aprire,
e ma
si fa mattino,
compagni, tu non aprire, e
che la passa, ma questi fa,
e si fa mattino,
e la vittima, e la vittima,
e
la spara,
venerabile arrospite,
non temete di lui, sarà mia cura. Impeti da restar, un giovin folle, dei soldati e del popolo, se la torba stagnata, e gli altari, e la gloria sicura. Mi compia il dover nostro, e del resto, ti lasci al ciel la cura.
Thank you. suona col cor, posto sospeso della sacerdotessa il velo sia e al suo fatale error questa perdona. Incenerir fra poco vedrem la spoglia al celeste foco.
Thank you. nostri altari, siate or romani i difensori.
Amici, i protettori siate dell'innocenza.
Thank you.
You can talk about the Marlon Brando film that I was wonderful in. All the positive things along that period. The Marlon Brando film was going on at the same time that the Lloyd Webber stupidity was going on. And you all have to put in the Lloyd Webber stupidity. You can't put in that I worked with the wonderful Marlon Brando and talked to the director of that movie, for Christ's
sake. Oh, we're back. Well, since Leila Jenser was our prima donna for tonight's podcast, we really should hear a little more from her. Here's La Gensa in arias from two Verdi operas, Don Carlo and Attila.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Shaker again, calling from an unmarked payphone. Don't bother to try to find me because I'm going into hiding until, well, until next week, right here at Unnatural Acts of Opera.